Well, the upper Midwest is getting a full dose of winter weather right now.
In North Dakota, the snow has moved out, but frigid temperatures have set in. Tomorrow's high in North Dakota is one below zero. Chris says we'll be in the mid-teens in the Twin Cities. Can it be too cold to snow, though? Good question. Heather Brown didn't quite brave the elements to find out.
I feel a little like I'm cheating today. Like, we should be asking these questions outside.
Oh, it's okay. Yeah. Don't.
Nope. It's what the Skyway system is for.
There's cold.
When the hair inside my nose starts freezing.
And then there's cold.
For the first time in my life, my thigh muscles actually begin to freeze.
Are you from Minnesota?
Yes, born and raised.
So you've heard the phrase, it's too cold to snow.
Oh, absolutely.
So I feel like this is something we just tell ourselves.
Allie Keslick is a meteorologist with the National Weather Service.
It certainly makes people feel a lot better, you know, to hear that, but it's not true.
Not in the science.
Back in January of 1994, it snowed 8 inches.
It's too cold for humans, that's all I can say.
With a low temp of negative 15.
So where does this come from?
God says, you know what? They're already freezing their butts off. Let's hold back on the snow.
It can get less likely to snow, but not impossible.
The colder it gets, the less moisture there is in the air.
Because the air can't physically hold that much moisture when it gets colder.
This would partly explain why our two biggest snowstorms in the Twin Cities were during Halloween in 1991 and late November 1985. Winter hadn't even officially started.
I hope it snows. I don't mind snowing. But when it doesn't snow and it doesn't look pretty and it's this cold, then that's when I have a problem with it.
At what temperature is it too cold to snow?
Our absolute zero, which is negative 273 degrees Celsius.
Okay. Oh, that is freezing.
Heather Brown.
And thank goodness we'll never get that low.
Exactly.
WCCO 4 News.
Well, March used to be our snowiest month, but January overtook it a few years ago. And that's not because we're getting walloped with bigger storms in January, but actually we're getting smaller, more frequent snowfalls. How about that one lady? I like her thought, like, God's having sympathy on us because it's so cold. So we'll see if that holds true in Chris's forecast.